To the rest of the day's news now, and Iran has launched a sweeping retaliatory strike against Israel, firing hundreds of attack drones and deadly missiles. It's an extraordinary escalation in the Middle East, and tonight America is giving an ironclad guarantee it will stand with Israel.
Missiles raining down on Israel as Iran began its widespread airborne attack. Tehran unleashing hundreds of kamikaze drones, then came a wave of cruise and ballistic missiles.
There's the sirens now.
The airstrikes lighting up the sky, Israel's Iron Dome defence system kicking in. This attack had been anticipated. Tonight, defences bolstered by American and British fighter jets.
A number of Iranian missiles fell inside Israeli territory, causing minor damage to a military base.
Across the region, air raid sirens sounding. Israelis told to shelter indoors as their Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu convened his war cabinet, vowing retribution. Whoever harms us, we will harm them back, he says. The barrage lasting hours.
Tonight, wide-scale attack by Iran is a major escalation.
America steadfast in its support, the US president making an ironclad guarantee to stand by its ally. Then, an urgent phone call between Biden and Netanyahu before the US president moved to convene G7 leaders to coordinate a united diplomatic response to Iran's brazen attack. Amid deep concerns, this war will widen.
We don't want conflict in the Middle East to be broader and deeper than it already is. We've already seen enough lives lost.
Multiple thresholds have been crossed here that have not been crossed before. I think it is correct to say that we're going to be looking at a new Middle East in the future.
The current Middle East aware of the aerial threat. Jordan declaring a state of emergency, shutting down its airspace. Iraq and Syria following suit. As the bombardment hit, Iranian state TV was calling the attack a response to crimes by the evil Zionist regime. Celebrations breaking out on the streets of Tehran. Death to Israel, they chant. Iran's embassy in the UN says the attack had been concluded, but warned against Israeli retaliation. Iran's response will be considerably more severe. Hours before the aerial bombardment in Israel, it was on the sea where Iranian forces struck. Iran's Revolutionary Guard carrying out a helicopter raid in the Persian Gulf, seizing a Portuguese cargo ship with Israeli links. Tonight, the threat of Middle Eastern conflict growing, and the United Nations Secretary General issuing a desperate warning, the world can't afford another war. In the United States, Lauren Tomasi, 9 News.